Hey guys, I'm in the van again. Don't show my face this often, that often, and I'm not going to show it for long this time. But was looking around, glad to be back in the van. So what's been happening? Well, the van was in the shop again, this time the brakes. I've been doing a little patch and get along for a while with the brakes. Oh, lay down here for a little bit. I've been doing a little patch and get along for a while with the brakes. And it blew up on me. I'd put some hydraulic stop leak in there for a while and put some brake fluid in there, and it would last for a week or two or three, or a week or two, and then I had to put some more fluid in there. So I knew it was something that was going to bite me in the butt one time. So it bit me in the butt about the time I get paid, as usual. So instead of even worrying about it, I just says, okay, I just can't live with this. So I just went on and put it in the shop, had them do all the brakes, and had them do the parking brakes as well. And from what I understand, and these guys at least have good ratings, the issue was with the drum brakes in the back. The guy said he hadn't seen any that blown out in a while. And I don't know whether it was a fact or not, but I paid what I expected to pay. About $1,000. And that's just basically, you know, every major repair that I've done, I've gone in there with that assumption and never been disappointed. Well, I wouldn't be disappointed if it was less. I'd be a lot disappointed if it was more, and this was slightly more. But, okay, I've got brakes now. Brakes that feel good, maybe for the first time. So, I got them. And it's something about an old van. So far, the guys that I've been contacting in the van life community in my little range of chatting have all said that a van of a certain amount of age, probably 15 to 20 years, the majority of them have spent 15 to 20 years plus. The majority of them have spent at least $5,000 on repairs. And that's just basically the way it is. But with a van, I'm tired of showing my face, so let's see if I can reverse this and take a look at the van. Here's my more comfortable viewpoint, the van. I've got my 360-degree cameras over there. I'm not sure you can even see it from here. I gotta get closer, maybe. And then you can see that I can see all the way around me. I'm in a Walmart parking lot, surprise, surprise, very near where I work. No need for AC now. I've got the max air fan back here, pushing air in, and I've got the small Scirocco fan over here, helping me to distribute the air. So things are going pretty good. So and as I was getting to before, virtually everyone that I've had contact with or communication with have said that they had an old van and they spent about $4,000 to $5,000 on getting it up. You know, and that seems like a very, very bad investment, and it is, but you're not investing in this as a vehicle. It's investing it as a home. So even at the amount of money I've spent on the van since I purchased it, that would have been within 2 to 3 months rent and utilities. I believe three quarters of a year of profit from living in the van. And I'm concentrating now on getting the van in shape. So I may have it in the shop one more time. I need ball joints. I need tie rods. These are life and limb type things. I am not jaunting around my area, and I'm not going across country. I would have done that probably first and taken care of the brakes. But since I am basically, bound by the city limits or county limits or wherever, I am not, it's not like it's a severe issue that I'm running into by not being able to get out on the road and open it wide up. Well, I can open it wide up, but the wheel might come off. That's not that bad, but you know what I mean. So I just wanted to give you a quick rundown. Like I said, right now it's, I don't know, it's probably 7 or 8. It gets dark so early now, you know, because we're heading toward the vernal equinox? Can't recall what it is in December when we get the shortest day of the year. So we're heading that direction, slowly but surely. So I just wanted to mention that. Now I'm going to quit, and this old guy is going to lay down, relax, watch a few videos, and then maybe doze off. Heck, now I don't care when I go to sleep. I just go to sleep. In any case, I'll be back with you with some more videos. I want to show my cameras. I want to show some equipment I've gotten for my small area. So I've got to do that. So I'll be concentrating a little bit on that. And all the metal detecting people, you know, I've been sort of slacking off with the metal detecting, but I've been sort of fighting an uphill battle with general lifestyle here. So I haven't really had a chance to go out because I've always been concentrating on making sure I wasn't going to asphyxiate. But I'm going to get back at that. Right now it's taking me this long to get my feet under me. So now I'll be able to do more recreational activities instead of just concentrating on the van and making the van livable. And see, I've got a bunch of stuff here, but I've emptied this space out. All I've got to do now is just take stuff out. Every time I step out of this van, I'm taking one of these canvas bags full of stuff that's not coming back. In any case, you'll see it as it progresses. I'll talk to you later, and I'll also do a complete video on what you can expect from an old van, what I've gathered from other people, and what I've experienced. Talk to you later, and you have a wonderful day.